Hello everyone and welcome to my first Doctor Who custom action figure review in 4 months and my first showcase for 2021. Today I shall be taking a look at 3 exciting customs from the Third Doctor's era, and with the upcoming collection box set for Season 8, today I present to you the Daffodil Man or the Auton in their carnival disguise from Terror of the Autons. These customs today wouldn't have been possible if it weren't for at Doctor Who Photography on Instagram, who has designed the heads for these figures so beautifully, and to Greens 3D as well, who kindly printed out the heads. Taking a look at the figures themselves, so the overall bodies are the Dalek-Sek hybrid bodies from Series 3, with a straight repaint and swapping out the hands. So actually looking at the body, I painted the shirt and tie section first with a base white colour, and then the jacket I painted in a Citadel base colour Avalon Sunset, which is the perfect balance between a yellow not being too dark and not being too light. And then the trousers I used the same base white colour that I used for the shirt and tie. However, I did have to do a couple of coats because of painting white straight onto black. One thing I did leave on the figure as well were the spat shoes. Now, I didn't really see any point in painting them, so I just left them as they are. Moving on to the hands, I swapped them with a Primeval Nick Cutter hand, mainly because I had a load of them lying around, and to be honest, the Dalek-Sek hybrid hands don't work because they're mutant-y and Dalek-y. However, on the main Auton, obviously I did have to use the Auton gun hand from the classic figures. Although the bodies aren't 100% accurate, mainly because the Autons have a different style of jacket to what I've got here, I think it does work and it is very clear obviously what it's supposed to be. And I suppose if character options were ever going to make these figures, they might possibly go down this route. Who knows? And taking a look at the main draw of these customs, the heads. These were designed and rendered by Doctor Who Photography on Instagram, and they rendered 2 variants of the head, noticeably with a difference in the actual hat itself. The sculpts themselves are fantastic with all the detailing of the eyes, the nose, the mouth and ears, all the little detailing is so crisp and it's just been brought out fantastically and probably better than the actual props were back in the day. After these were printed, I did need to do a little bit of sanding, mainly around the rim of the hat, and then it was simply just applying the paint apps. And I think you can clearly see how the detailing does come through the paint apps, and to be honest, this sculpt could easily be for character options, it's that good. I did try to replicate the actual look of the masks in a smaller scale, and I think I managed to do that well with the sort of black eyeline around the eyes, the pupils, and the mouth. And one thing I have noticed whilst recording this, I forgot to paint the blusher on, so that is something I'm going to have to go back and do. And that's really all I can say. I am extremely happy with how these have turned out, and once again, a massive thank you to both Doctor Who Photography for the heads, and to Greens 3D who printed them so well for me as well. Thank you so much for watching this video, hope you're all safe and well. And if you have enjoyed this video, then feel free to like, comment and subscribe for more videos like this. Custom reviews are going to be coming back this year. And I shall see you next time. So until then, goodbye for now.
Don't forget
to click below and subscribe.
Well, how could I possibly forget that? For goodness sake. You got the message, haven't you? Don't forget.